Okay, today we're going to head to Vodno Mountain, which is the mountain to the south of the city. It's really close, it's right on the edge. It's a very foggy day today, but it should burn off by the time we make it to the top. It'll take about 20 minutes to get to the trailhead from here, from the center of the city. And up at the top, we should find the Millennial Cross, which is a pretty famous monument. And let's see what else is up there. Okay, it took me, I'd say, about 20 minutes to walk up the steep hill. It's a pretty steep hill too to get to this point. This is the trailhead. There's a couple of signs right here, one in English, one in the local language. So I'm gonna start my Garmin Fenix 5 trail thing. I'll put a link to that in the description if you want to see like the elevation, how long it took me, the temperature, all that kind of cool stuff. If you're into stats, it's kind of the Garmin watch is really cool. And I also have the foot pod here so I can track my pace as well. So let's see what's up here. In a little bit from the street. This is a residential area still. That's kind of a cool old shed. And you can see this is like the beginning of the trail. Looks like it's going to be pretty developed. Benches, garbages, fountains, just like all the other places. Oh, that's cool. So this is a massive park actually. And we're only going to like actually I think right here. So it's a pretty extensive trail. Oh, there's even a bike, mountain bike fixing thing. There's two trails that are marked by a circle and a like circles, and then other ones that are just straight lines. I'm not really sure the significance of the two. I think maybe difficulty. Well, the fog's burned off. Those are the straight line markings I was talking about. Okay, nearing the top. Okay, there's a cross. So the fog burned off. An amazing day today. Perfect temperature. Maybe I'm a little out of shape. It's a pretty steep climb. I took the hardest trail up, and the path wasn't too bad. A little bit muddy. If it rains, it probably couldn't do it, and you would have to take the road, which ends up here. But I'll show you what it looks like up here. We got the gazebo and some benches. It looks like they're building maybe a second cross or something. And there is a cable car that you can take from halfway up the hill, but it's not running right now because of COVID. And there's a little store up here. You can get some stuff, some snacks. And that's about it. I talked to a local. He said there's a restaurant, but they never finished it.
But you know, you could bring a picnic lunch up here. Be nice. Kids could play on the playground. And you can't drive all the way up here, it looks like. But what a view. We'll get up towards the cross and get a better view. Turn it back on in a second. There's the inoperable cable car. And that mountain right there, which I could see out my window, that's going towards Kosovo. It's the word for it is, there's not an English word for it, but it's basically a mountain of multicolors, or a ridgeline of multicolors, like a rainbow. And there's Skopje right down there below. That's a pretty big city once you see it from up here. But wow, what a beautiful view. Okay, I gotta be careful going down here. Once again, I did this hike and it's a muddy trail and I did it with running shoes. So it's not like super difficult. But yeah, that's a beautiful view. Look at that. Wow, it's amazing. Actually, I'm gonna get a picture of that really quick. Okay, now the hike down. Hello. Yeah, so definitely they're building something else here. If you know what's being built, maybe you could put it in the comments down below. So it took about an hour and a half to get up. That wasn't that long. Wow, look at that. You can see a bridge over there. And that's kind of where I'm living, right down in here in the center. Cool. Back down. Yeah, there's still some snow on the ground. And there's definitely mud. This is the hard trail to head down or up. This is what I came up as well. Going as I'm going down here, this is the steep course. You can see a bank, what we call a banker or a berm, down this snake run here. I guess there's a lot of mountain bikers that come down here, so if you're going uphill, you want to be kind of cognizant of that, getting run over by mountain bikes. This looks fun. It looks like an actual course. But yeah, it's kind of cool. And if you're a mountain biker, you might want to check this out. This is cool. Looks like all the hard trail markers have been blacked out on this section where the mountain bike berms are. I don't know if they want to dissuade hikers from going up there, but interesting. Crossing another path right here, or an old road. Doesn't look very used. Well, here's the jump I suspected there would be. So So you barrel on down here. It's like they haven't taken care of this for a long time, it looks like. But launch, had some kind of gap. There's a picnic area right here, right through these trees, right appearing through the light. So throughout the trail, on the main trail anyway, not the hard trail like I'm on, but there's all these pit stop areas where you can have a picnic. Beautiful park. Another jump. They don't have a landing for that. It's gonna be a hard one. That's a little bit slippery. By the way, halfway up the mountain is the halfway up the mountain is where you catch the cable car if you wanna. When and if it ever starts up again, that's where you can catch it. And there's a big rest area there, like a restaurant, picnic tables. You can, there's a fountain there, so you can get something to drink or wash your hands. Restrooms. So halfway up the hill, but once again, you can drive literally all the way to the top. So either way. Okay, now I'm back on the main road. I'm almost to the midway point where you can grab the cable car. You could take this road all the way up if you so choose, but it's so beautiful. The different trails, and like I said, there's easy. I went down a hard one. I went up and down a hard one, but there are easy trails. The easiest is being the road. You can just walk up the road. And there's like two or three others that are marked that varying different levels, and they have it posted on the billboards. So anyway, so keep going. Okay, so this is the midway point. They even have a mountain rescue, I guess. But you know, parking lot, restaurant. You can't, there's not really a view from up here, so I mean, come up here to go for a picnic in the woods would be kind of nice, maybe, but to get out of the pollution of the city, get some somewhat fresher air, right? Yeah, big playground, looks like lots of food vendors. Yeah, you get your chips, your ice cream, cotton candy, all your junk food. Yeah, that's where you catch the, if it was open, the gondola thing. People leaving their trash. And there's garbage cans right there. Okay. Now let's finish the hike off. Oh, that's a cool car. Oh, that's super cool. Not sure what kind of car it is though. If anyone knows, maybe you could put it in the comments. Looks like the same car you drive in PUBG. And there's lots of the street dogs, tag street dogs up here. And they're super tame. You don't have to worry about them. Okay, let's head on down. Okay, so the midpoint is here. This is the only trail going back into Skopje from the midpoint. It's moderate trail, moderate to light. More upkept, easier on the knees. Okay, let's make it back down to the trailhead. Old ruin. Man, it's really deteriorated. It must be really old. Maybe a restaurant or something. You know, in Portland, well, it has some nice stonework on there too. Okay, let's head on down. Just keep following the marks. Yeah, see, they even got stairs on the steep spots, which is super nice. Going down, this time of day is beautiful, and you can see the, I can't pronounce the name in Slavic, but it's the Rainbow Mountain type range over there, and the city down below, absolutely gorgeous. And this is, once again, you're only halfway up the mountain, so you don't even have to go all the way up to get a beautiful view. It's kind of cool. It's a little dam, breakwater, reservoir, whatever you want to call it. Doesn't look used anymore. Almost to the bottom. It's cool. I like it in here. Okay, well, that's basically the trail. Trailhead is literally just maybe like, you know, 50 meters down this way. Now this is where this dam breakwater thing is for the water coming down to break its fall. And in here, from this point on, you'll see kind of little, you know, summer, I don't know what they call them, like growing shacks and stuff where people can hang out, little cottages. It's pretty cool. But that was a hike. Definitely, if you're in Skopje, you have to come here and check it out. This is definitely a worthwhile adventure. Until next time, catch you later. Oh, bunch of beehives. Yeah, a bunch of beehives down here. They look old. Like no one's used them in a long time. Huh. Oh, back to the start. That's it.